because these are few things which are going to change the world around us. So we talk a lot about the IoT, that is the Internet of Things, and from a corporate side, I've worked for past 18 years in appliance industry, and I would like to tell you how the things are going to change for us as an appliance industry. अभी तक हमने जो भी देखा, हम जाते हैं, मुझे आज गाड़ी खरीदनी, मुझे आज रेफ्रिजरेटर खरीदना है, मैंने आज रेफ्रिजरेटर खरीद लिया, मुझे आज टीवी खरीदना है, मैंने आज टीवी खरीद लिया, मुझे आज वाटर प्यूफर खरीदना है, मैंने आज वाटर प्यूफर खरीद लिया. गोइंग फॉरवर्ड द एंटायर इंडस्ट्री इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू चेंज एंड इज गोइंग टू चेंज फ्रॉम अ प्रोडक्ट टू अ सर्विस लेड इंडस्ट्री. पीपल विल बी नो लॉन्गर बाइंग अ प्रोडक्ट, दे विल बी यूजिंग अ सर्विस. This is one change which is going to hit our industry a lot. I need a car, I need to come to attend this function. I'll request for a car will come, I'll drive a car, I'll come here and I'll go back in the car which I'll order again. I'll not own a car. I need a suit, a shirt to come to this event. I'll order it online, I'll get a suit and shirt, I'll wear it, I'll come and I'll return it back. This is what the industry is going to be, and we say this from a product to a service led industry, and we all have to prepare for it. Then there was one very important thing which touched by sir is the fourth industrial revolution, industry 4.4, and it is really good that the already those things are there being discussed here, people are being talked about it. I believe the when I graduated from my college, and not only my graduation, even the last 10-12 years which I have spent in the industry, I have not done anything on these. It is the time when I am also learning these things, and it is really really wonderful that you guys are going to learn these things from your college. Your basics will be far more superior to what basics we have now, because we are now making a product. We are not learning, we are making a product now. And while we are making a product, then we see everything from a product perspective. We don't see from a basic perspective. Basic, that is the education, sir. And you guys will be following your basics, and when you will come to the industry having all those basics ready, I think you are going to make a big difference into it. Industry 4.0, is bring the fourth industrial revolution, started from when we use the steam engines, electricity, automation, and this is the fourth revolution that will come by Industry 4.0, and it is expected the internet and the physical world will get connected. There will be a lot of things that will be happening. Lot of decision making will be happening by the machines, and there will be algorithms running based on artificial intelligence and machine learning that will be improving by themselves. So we all have to prepare ourselves for this. From here, most of the points have been discussed, and it's really wonderful to hear the other members. Few things which is I'd like to add here that can help you in becoming industry ready in your coming 2 years, which you are going to stay here. First and foremost thing which I'll say is please focus on the innovation. Innovation is the key. Wherever we are in the current situation, we have to understand, as sir has mentioned about the observation, we have to be very observative. Very rightly said, sir, really appreciate that point. All of us have to be very observative. If we will not observe, if we will not innovate, we should find an area, we should see what all socio-economic problems are there in our country, where we can innovate, where we can make life of our consumers, of our fellow citizens of the country better. We have to look at that picture. You know, India is the fastest growing nation in the world, and it is going to be the fastest nation in the next years. We are getting a lot of support by the government also in taking our country to a $5 trillion GDP. But more than this, I believe it is the power of the people here that is going to take our country to that level, and maybe much far away from that level. Second point which I would like to hear, which we think can be useful for us, we have to be limitless. Today there is no limit, there is no boundary which we cannot close, achieve. I tell you a very simple example. I am part of Hindware group. Most of you might be aware about the Hindware group. So we have almost more than 30 crore consumer space in our country. That means we are connected to almost 6 crore families. So Hindware is a very known name in the entire country. We start a part of this group is thought of, let's start an appliance business. So we started appliance business in 2015. And first year of our operations, we did a turnover for around 15-16 crore rupees. From there, in last 4 years, we grow at a CAGR of more than 60%, and last year we closed almost 380 crores of turnover. And it is important, definitely it is important what turnover we achieve in the appliance part of the Hindware. What milestones we count is, we are the fastest to reach in the top 3 in the kitchen chimney segment. We are the fastest to reach 200,000 water heaters, which the industry leader took almost 20 years. We are the fastest to reach 150,000 air coolers. Because we don't see where we are. What we see is what opportunity we have in front of us. And not only this is just the beginning. In last 2.5 years, we have registered more than 20 patents, which are going to come into our products. And that will be taking us to the next level from here. So my request to all of you is, please don't consider any boundary. Anything is possible to be achieved. The more and more we try to exert ourselves, more and more we can improve. More and more we can achieve. If all of us sir also have shared this point, that if we study hard, we can improve our knowledge. If we play, we can improve our skills. If we interact with as many people as possible around us, we can improve our skills, we can be better in the interviews we face. So don't keep yourself under any boundary, just go out and try yourself. Next most important point which I see is the competency. There is no doubt. Whatever we want to do, we have to be competent. We have talked about our Honorable Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi today, and most of us agree the good thing he has done for the country in the past years, and we expect also the same in the future as well. But one very important thing which I always follow and want to follow from him is, the first day when Mr. Narendra Modi enters the Vidhan Sabha, he was the Chief Minister of the state. The first day he enters the Lok Sabha, he was the Prime Minister of the country. This is competency. There are people who have spent more than decades being the MLA, MP of the region, but not being the MP of any place, directly he become the Prime Minister of the country. This is competency. We have to learn what is required, we have to prepare ourselves, we have to see what all things we need to learn to be, to make ourselves competent. And that can be anything. You want to be a competent in a sport, you want to be competent in a job, you want to be a competent in a social service, it can be anything. But this is what I personally benchmark Mr. Narendra Modi, that I want to become a competent person. Some of you might even become a competent that 2 years you do your education in this college, and when you go out you become the CEO of the company. It all depends on what kind of competence you try to achieve in these 2 years. Next, is the relentless. Nobody can beat a person who is relentless to achieve his objectives. You have to work relentlessly. No tiring, no excuses. It has to be a relentless approach if you want to groom yourself. Sir, I know a very beautiful Sanskrit shlok, but I'm sorry, I'm not so good in Sanskrit, but it's the same meaning which he has said. And in spite of doing all those things, being innovation, limitless, and then comes to your competency, comes to being hardworking, success and failures will still be the part of your life, and we have to be ready. If we are successful, then we have to maintain our humbleness. If we are failure, we have to stay calm, continue our efforts, because failures are always short term. If you are putting your efforts in a right direction, then in long term you will be definitely a successful person. Nobody can beat that. And last is the health and happiness. You know, healthy mind stays in a healthy body. We have to be healthy. I would like to share one very important thing over here is, in my previous organization, हम लोग consumer research करते थे. हम consumer research के लिए हम consumer के यहाँ जाते थे. हम उनसे पूछते थे कि आप हमारा product कैसा लगा? आप क्या इसमें सुधार चाहते हो? क्या हमें इसमें चेंज करना चाहिए ताकि हमें वहाँ से वो आइडियाज़ मिले. उन आइडियाज़ को फिर हम आके डेवलप करते हैं, उनके अराउंड हम टेक्नोलॉजी बनाते हैं. तो हमने कंज्यूमर से सबसे पहले ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वी यूज्ड टू मेक वाटर प्यूरीफायर एज वेल. तो हमने कंज्यूमर सबसे पहले पूछा कि वाटर प्यूरीफायर जब आप लेते हैं तो आपको सबसे ज़्यादा अच्छी चीज़ क्या चाहिए. वो कहते हैं कि ये वाटर प्यूरीफायर खरीदते हैं तो पानी साफ होना चाहिए बिल्कुल, और कुछ नहीं. हाइजीन इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग. वाटर प्यूरीफायर खरीदा ही इसलिए हमने, साफ पानी होना चाहिए. अब हम फिर ध्यान से देखते हैं कि ये साफ पानी की बात करें, इसका मतलब कंज्यूमर की सबसे बड़ी रिक्वायरमेंट है कि पानी साफ मिलना चाहिए. हम देखते हैं कि जो टैंक है उसमें छोटे 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 पार्टिकल्स हैं. हम टैप देखते हैं, उसमें कहीं थोड़ी थोड़ी सी वो एल्गी फॉर्मेशन हो गई है. हम उस वॉश बेसिन के अराउंड का एरिया देखते हैं तो वहाँ पर थोड़े 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 हमें एल्गी फॉर्मेशन दिखती है जो कि बैक्टीरिया ग्रोथ को बढ़ा सकती है. पॉइंट हेयर इज वी नो अबाउट इट, वी आर कंसर्न अबाउट इट. हमें पता है हेल्थ होनी चाहिए, हमें पता है हमें साफ पानी होना चाहिए, बट हम ऐसा कोई एक्शन नहीं लेते जिससे हम इस चीज को अचीव करें. देयर इज अ सेपरेट थिंग. देन वी स्टार्टेड डेवलपिंग सम टेक्नोलॉजीज इन विच ये पार्टिकल्स टैंक में ना जाएं. इवन कोई बैक्टीरिया ग्रोथ टैंक के अंदर हो भी रही है तो वो ना हो. इनफैक्ट सर, वी डेवलप ए टेक्नोलॉजी कि अगर जो आपकी टैप है, टैप में भी अगर कोई एलईडी फॉर्मेशन है, यूवी एलईडी लाइट विल कम एंड दैट विल किल ऑल द बैक्टीरिया इनसाइड द टैप. सो एवरीथिंग इज पॉसिबल, बट व्हाट पॉइंट आई एम हियर, द हेल्थ इज वन थिंग विच 100% ऑफ अस नोस दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बट नॉट मोर देन 10% ऑफ द अस विल डू समथिंग टू इम्प्रूव इट. तो दैट इज वन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. हैप्पीनेस comes with health, balanced diet, life fit lifestyle, and in fact a balanced lifestyle. Having a work-life balance is also very important. Interact with as many people as possible and try to do whatever new things you can do and whatever comes your way, try to do all those things. So these are some points which I think if you will be following in next 2 years and furthermore, then you will be developing yourself and grooming yourself for the industries and you will be really fit for the industries. Please take this 2 years in the college and the further 8 years in the industry. These 10 years are the most critical part of your journey. These 10 years are going to define where you are going to be in your professional life. So work hard on these 10 years, make a strong foundation. हमें 80 फ्लोर की बिल्डिंग बनाते हैं जब हम आते हैं नोएडा से. एक बिल्डिंग है सुपरनोवा, 80 फ्लोर का क्लेम है वो बनाएंगे. Suppose you have to make this kind of building in your life, you know, the first and most important thing is that you work on the foundation. And I think the way college is geared up with the new technologies, they are going to work on your foundation, and the same things you, all of you also should work on your foundation. Make a very strong foundation, and if you are able to make a strong foundation, you are going to build a not only 180 story building as well on that. Outside world is very challenging, but it's full of opportunity. If you prepare yourself, the day you come out of this college, you can be the CEO. The owner of Ola is a 25-year person, and he has made a $8 billion company. So this is the opportunity which is there outside world. We are looking for people who understand the corporate culture, they know how the corporates work, so that when they come to us, we can adapt them immediately. They are already ready for us. So try to have that kind of industrial exposure as much as possible, because everything, college have 2 years or 6 months of internship. Take that part very seriously, because the more I was going through an article, it was saying that a US national, a person from a US national to come join office and start delivering, its time is less than 2 months. For an Indian person coming to office, joining your office and start delivering, time is 8 months. And this is a big time you have to come, you have to reduce. So more, take your all internship very seriously. If it's not only internship, if you can work upon some ideas while you are doing education, that will help you. You know, I spent my entire life in a corporate world doing a job. At times, I meet some of the startup people. They are into startup for 4 years, not more than four years or 5 years max. The amount of learning these guys have in 4 years is huge. Probably I see the people under me, they don't have that kind of learning even in 10 years. So if you can get a chance, start working on some ideas. I am telling the learning you will get working on these ideas, nobody can match it. Find an idea, make an aim, and start working on it. You can apply all your principles which you will be learning in this institute to that particular idea, and nothing can be better than that. The day you will be going for your interview, you will be almost 90% ready to be get absorbed. So I once again say, the world outside is challenging, but definitely it's full of opportunities. And if you are ready, then you can come and you can deliver, and then success is all yours. So I once again wish all of you best of luck. I hope that all of you will become the great leaders of the future. And I'm really thankful to the entire management for giving me this opportunity to come here and interact with you. It's a learning experience for me as well. And really delightful that the education institutes are getting so actively involved in developing people for the future technologies. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone.